Hi, welcome to Lead. Now, the other day, a startup founder asked me, hey, Dr. Lau, what is full stack development and why do we need to know about it? So today, I'm going to discuss this question. Now, first of all, before we look into full stack development, let's look at how website works. Imagine today you go to browsers and you want to visit, say, Google. So you enter google.com in the address bar, but your browser will not go straight to the Google server first. It will actually go to a DNS server and translate google.com to an IP address. And then our browser will go to that IP address and download a set of files from HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and the supporting files like image files, and render it display on your local browser. This is how a website and web application works, and also known as the client-server architecture. Whether you are browsing Google, Facebook, eBay, or a smaller website like Lead, or my website, drhanlao.com, we're all using the same architecture. Now, you have understood how website and the internet works. Let's look at full-stack development. Full-stack development consists of four major components, from front-end, back-end, databases, to a server. Let's first talk about front-end. Front-end is everything that your user sees and interacts. For example, the text, the videos, and also the images. Every single website that you see on the internet today are using the same exact languages to build their front-end, which are HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. No more, no less. Front-end languages alone are sufficient for us to build a static website. For example, a profile for your cat, or a menu for the restaurant website. Today, if we are building a dynamic website like Airbnb, Lazada, and Taobao, we actually need back-end development. In short, back-end is the part where your user can't see, and we use programming languages like PHP and Node.js to help us to write functionalities that handles your business logic, such as browsing your products, place a booking, orders, and accept payment. So after we have set up our back-end and front-end, what we need to do is we need to find a place to store our data. And this is where databases come in. Now for databases, we have common ones like the relational databases such as Microsoft SQL and MySQL. If we are storing something that is non-relational, we may use unstructured database like MongoDB and Firebase that help us to store text, documents, messages, or product reviews and user comments. Full-stack developers don't really need to master the database design at the very beginning, but you definitely need to know how to read and write data to the database at the very minimum. And lastly, we'll need a place to host our web applications. At the beginning, when you don't have a huge volume of traffic, you may start with shared hosting solutions like Exabyte, HostGator, or GoDaddy. And once you have more traffic for your website and you require advanced functionalities, then you might opt for cloud-based hosting solutions like Google Cloud Platform, AWS, or Microsoft Azure. All right, so what I've covered here are four key components in full-stack development. Remember, every website, web application that you use, be it the giants like eBay, Facebook, Google, or the smaller one like Lead or any personal websites, we're all using the same client-server architectures and HTML, CSS, and JavaScript to build our front ends. The things that are different here are like the frameworks, the databases, the type of back-end languages that we choose that is suitable for our website functionalities, and the amount of traffic we're handling. Mobile applications are using a similar architecture as well, and I will cover it when I have time in the future videos. Alright, thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to like it and share it with a friend who is currently learning full stack development. Like our Facebook page and subscribe to our YouTube channel for future videos like this. Thank you, and I'll see you in the next video.